Boy. Now, God, as we open up this service and the worship experience unto you, oh God, Lord, we just ask that you come on in, oh God. Transform us, oh God, and give us the needs of the hour. And we will forever give your name all the praise, God. We will give you all the glory. In Jesus' precious name we ask it all. Amen. And at this time, Elder Deidre Irvin will come with our offertory.
Good morning, Mount Carmel family and friends. I greet you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord. What a blessing it is to get up this morning and just be able to say good morning. Yes. Truly a blessing today. In Exodus chapter 23, verse 19, the word says, "Bring the best of your first fruits of your soil to the house of the Lord your God." And 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 7 through 8 says, "Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver." And God is able to do, and he is blessing us abundantly in all things, at all times, having all that you need. We here at Mount Carmel believe when we offer our first fruits, we are attracting divine increase. So in addition to offering your tithes and offers, consider just planting a seed of $20, $50, $100, whatever the Lord places on your heart, so that we may continue to move and advance the kingdom of God over in this particular area of the vineyard. We thank you in advance for all that you have already given, whether it's through sending a check to our P.O. box, through our Cash App or Givelify. We just want to say thank you. Each time that you have sown into this ministry, remind yourself by saying, "I am a cheerful giver. I plant good seed and good soil. Mount Carmel is good soil." And you are watching the wondrous works of God. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we just say thank you for all of the financial seeds that continue to pour in and be sown into this ministry. We ask that you will allow Mount Carmel to be a blessing to the community and the surrounding area in many diverse ways because of the seed that has been planted by our Mount Carmel family members and friends. Lord, we ask that you will multiply each and every seed and give us insight, wisdom, and understanding to use it accordingly. We give you all honor, glory, and praise that we are able to continue to give in this season. Amen. And it is now preaching time. Hallelujah. It is time for us to receive God's mighty word. And it is my pleasure at this time to announce our pastor, Overseer Leon Rogers.
Good morning to everyone. God bless you. Hallelujah for the precious Lamb of God. We are just so thankful that God has blessed us again to come into his midst. Father, we thank you for your love, for your graciousness, and for your mercy. You know, we have just come through a season of dealing with our voting and all of the things that have gone on. I want to thank Mount Carmel in particular, for we are a voting site, and we just want to thank all of those that helped us through the process. We have many people that had come to open the doors and facilitate water for those that needed it, and showing people the restrooms or the facilities, and just being a delightful presence. And even in the midst of that, one person saw the love of us and even helped to do some things around our church from a financial standpoint. So we just want to thank all of you for allowing that to come to fruition. God has been so good, and we just thank God for who he is in our lives. Amen. We emulate who he is, which is love. Amen. Let us bow in a word as we prepare for the word today. Gracious Lord our God, we thank you for being with us and for carrying us through the busyness of the past week. Father, we love you and we thank you for what you have done, what you're doing, and for the things to come. Bless us now as we open our hearts, our minds, and souls to hear of your word. Father, allow us to be the conduit for which the word will flow. Bless us now. In Jesus' name we do pray. And let the hearts of the minds of everyone say amen. Amen. I want to come to you from today, from one of our, they call him a minor prophet, but that just only in word, only because he is one that has significant input. And I really want you to know that Brother Jeremiah is somebody that I want to hear from. Amen. He cried, amen, for the fears of the people and things that were going on and trying to get people to repent. But I thought that because of the climate we're in, where it just seems like we're not loving one another the way we ought, I just feel that we ought to go to these prophets that told us many, many years ago the things that were going to happen. So from Jeremiah, first chapter, and I'm going to start at verse 4. Amen. The first few verses just tell you who he is. Amen. But I want to start at verse 4 where God speaks directly to Jeremiah. Jeremiah 1, chapter 1, verse 4. And it reads as follows. And the word of Yahweh came to me saying, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. And before you came out from the womb, I consecrated you. Ah, yes. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. Then, verse 6, then I said, ah, Lord Yahweh, look, I do not know how to speak. For I am a youth. But Yahweh said to me, you must not say, I am a youth. For to whomever I send you, you will go. Let me say that again. To whomever I send you, you will go. And whatever I command you, you will speak. Verse 8, do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, declares Yahweh. Verse 9, then Yahweh stretched out his hand, and he touched my mouth. And Yahweh said to me, look, I have put my words on your mouth. See, I appointed you this day over the nations and over the kingdoms to pluck up and to pull down and to destroy and to tear down, to build and to plant. Verse 11, and the word of Yahweh came to me saying, what are you seeing, Jeremiah? And I said, I am seeing a branch of an almond tree. Oh, yes, amen. And then verse 12, and then I'll conclude the reading. Then Yahweh said to me, you did well to see, for I am watching over my word to perform it. Hallelujah. May the Lord have a blessing upon the reading, hearing, and the doing of his precious word. Today, just for a thought, I just want to talk today, amen, the awakening. I just want to talk on that topic, the awakening. There was something very prophetic about what was going on in Jeremiah. When I look at the book of Jeremiah, it's about Yahweh's goodness and his people's refusal to follow his ways. Yeah, it's also a portrayal of Jeremiah's persistence in following his prophetic call despite indifference and opposition. Jeremiah warned Judah, the southern kingdom of God, of Israel, of God's judgment. But Yahweh ultimately provides us hope. Yeah, promising to renew his covenant with his people. Jeremiah proclaims that God had long ago established a contractual agreement with them and will restore that relationship with them. Yeah, somebody ought to say thank you, Lord. Because when I look at what's going on in this country, there seems to be such divide, the division and strife and issues. I was looking on TV last night talking about the walks going on
in D.C. and how Washington, D.C. and how folk just weren't getting along. But I'm here to tell you that there's something about the awakening. God had to awaken Jeremiah that you don't have the power, I've got the power. You don't have the words, I got the words. It doesn't matter how old, how young, how stupid, how smart you are, I will give you everything you need. Yes, yes. Some time ago, I preached on a sermon, Stay Woke. Yeah, and to stay awake is a slang term that is easing in the mainstream from a variety of dialects. And one of the things that I found is to stay woke, to stay awake, and to realize that God has a way of helping us to see things differently. Yeah, the word awake in itself declares as woke, as in I was sleeping, but now I'm woke. I know that ain't proper language. I know you can't find in the dictionary, but in the African American vernacular English, that word woke is increasingly used by increasingly used as a byword for social awareness. I want us to realize that you got to stay woke, and God is helping everybody to stay woke. He allowed for Corona to come. He allowed for cancer to still be here. He allowed for the racial things that are going on. Now, I didn't say he brought it, but he's allowed. Oh, y'all not walking. We need to understand God is in charge. God's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. During this current presidential period, I recalled how Homeland Security had become a major topic just a few years ago. And you could not even watch the nightly news without some measurement of security, measurement of talking about the security of the country coming up. The advent of terrorism actually came to this nation through what we call 9-1-1. Yeah, has coined a new phrase in our lexicon in the government called Homeland Security. Yeah, in this New World Order, where Code Orange seemed to be the prevailing color of the day. Are y'all not hearing me? We need to stay woke every morning with the hope that the powers that be are watching over us. Yeah, we heard about various other colors. Yeah, we hear about Code Red, and right now, the state of Ohio has got a high level of Code Red, and then there's the opportunity that it may turn into Code Purple. But I'm here to tell you today that there's also Code Orange, yeah, Code Blue, which means a medical first emergency situation has popped up. But I'm here to tell you that there's also Code Orange. Code Orange is used in regards to expressing external disaster with mass casualties. Yeah, we seem to be more conscious more than ever of our surroundings as each of us yearn for the security of knowing that we are protected and our families will not befall some unimaginable tragedy. Facebook, you ought to mention, I was sleeping, but now I'm woke. Yeah, this idea of homeland security may seem new to us, but the truth is the spiritual realm, home security, has always been around. Since the birth of mankind, God has incorporated his own form of homeland security. Yeah, God swallowed up Pharaoh's army in the midst of the Red Sea. Yeah, that was holy Department of Homeland Security. Yeah, yeah. God sent his only begotten son to cool off the fiery furnace for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. That was God's homeland security in action. Yeah. God shut up the mouth of the lions in put Daniel. That's homeland security. God delivered Joseph, Mary, and Jesus from Herod's wrath, sent them to Egypt. That was homeland security. In the text today, Jeremiah the prophet is about to assume the position of chief of homeland security for the chosen people of God. Yeah, it was a tough century, but then every century is tough. Yeah, not just ours, but maybe that's why Jeremiah cried so much. Because you know, he was called the weeping prophet. Yeah, and as he comes to be known, he carried a persistent message of God's judgment, but also God's salvation. Yeah. Jeremiah's task was as God's homeland security and advisor for the nation of Israel. Yeah, he called to declare the coming judgment of God and the promise of deliverance to those who obey God. Yeah, God called to Jeremiah as a prophet, contained a message designed to motivate him for his task. God revealed that his selection of Jeremiah as a prophet had occurred even before he was born. Yeah. Listen to what he says in Jeremiah 1, 4 and 6. Then the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, before I formed you in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee a prophet unto the nation. I want you to know that I could just replace his word, his name, and put my name in there. I wish I had a witness that God called you before you even was formed. That God had sanctified you and had ordained you to carry forth the word of God. Yeah. When it talks about that he knew you before, let me explain that for just a moment, because sometimes our intellectual processes get in the way. Yeah. See, in Genesis 4 and 1, it was used, knew was used to describe an intimate relationship experienced between husband and wife. Yeah, in Amos 3 and 2, it conveyed the sense of close personal relationship. The word knew in Psalms 1, 6, it conveyed the promise of protection. Yeah, in this case, the word knew confirmed that before Jeremiah was conceived, God had singled him out to be his spokesperson to Israel. Yeah, Elder Deidre, I want you to know, before you were formed, oh, you ought to shout right now, that God confirmed in your spirit that you've been singled out to be a spokesperson for the Lord. Minister Donna, I know you can shout, I know you can sing, but God called you before you were formed, before you became who you are, and anointed you, had confirmed you, had appointed you to be a spokesperson for God. Hallelujah for the Lamb. Jeremiah had been set apart for this ministry. The verb translation of set apart means something or someone apart for a specific purpose. Individual or object were set apart, yeah, sanctified and made holy for holy use, yeah. The Sabbath day was set apart, yeah. The tabernacles and the furnishings are set apart. The priests are set apart. Leon is set apart. Donna is set apart. Lionel is set apart. Oh, I wish I could call the roll right now. Yeah, God had marked Jeremiah from the conception to be set apart. God reserved Jeremiah for a special task. He was appointed to be a prophet to the nation and to carry the message that God would provide homeland security, and if they only obey his order. See, Jeremiah was full of excuses, just like many of us. I ran for many years. I felt the anointing at the age of 12, but I didn't listen until I was in my 40s. I need somebody to know that when God calls you, you can run, but you can't hide. Hallelujah. Full of excuses, Jeremiah was. He did not want to be God's homeland security advisor. He was full of self-doubt. Some of his language was, I can't talk right, Lord. I'm too young and inexperienced to deal with the issues. But if Jeremiah had responded with confidence, the Lord would have had the wrong man. I'm here to tell you that God got to work out a great work on you to get you down the right path. How many of you know that in order to do the great work of God, you have to humble yourself, pray, seek God's face, turn from your wicked ways. And the Lord said, I'll hear from heaven, forgive you of your sins, and will heal your lands. You need to take a back seat to God's power. God turned self-doubt into submission. If we could do things our own way, we wouldn't need God. Ask Moses. He used the same excuse when he was on the mountaintop. He said, God, I'm a stumbling man. I can't talk right. But the Lord told him, who do I say sent me? He said, tell them I am sent you. I'm here to tell somebody that somebody may not know, but you're the anointed of God. And I want you to realize that despite your fears, God knows how to make you real good. Well, under God's authority, Jeremiah was to take the message to everybody. Oh, y'all not hearing me. No picking and choosing. The eloquence was not a requirement for the job. Just be faithful. And just second, God said, protect your hill, protect his homeland security advisor. There was no need for Jeremiah to be afraid, because God will fight your battles. And then the third thought, God showed Jeremiah the source of the message. The Lord reached out, touched his mouth, and told him, there will be a visible manifestation of God's objective lesson to show the people that I am real. I want you to know that I can imagine right now, maybe Biden doesn't realize it, but God was selected by God before he came in the womb. He tried for 47 years, but God had him for the right time, at the right moment. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us. Jeremiah would not have worried about what to say. God will provide the very words to come out of his mouth. One of the things during this period that we've been in, I spent a lot of time praying to God. Apparently a lot of people have been praying to him. But I pray that your prayers are heard. Yeah. I shared with the church in our Bible study yesterday that I know God heard what we were asking. And one of the things that I asked God for wasn't about being a Republican, wasn't about being a Democrat, but I asked God for a morality and for spirituality to enter the person that would help us to get out of the fix we're in. And I declare to you today, God heard our cry. The awakening is for us to hear what God is telling us to do. Don't be silent, because there are many people right now that are in the administration. They are being silent because they're afraid of man. But I'm here to tell you, God is telling us, don't be afraid. Stand on God's word. God is telling us that he'll help you to overcome what is fearful. Let me give you the crux of the lesson. Don't sign off yet, because you'll miss it. What did Jeremiah see? In that last verse I read to you, he said, I see the rod of an almond tree. Yeah, while Israel was locked in the winter of relaxation from God, God would be watching and planning and waiting. He promised to be Jeremiah's rod of correction and protection for Israel. And they might once again bring forth fruit in their season. Yeah. Now watch this. I am the awake tree, Jeremiah. I don't sleep on the job. I'm explaining it in a minute. I was the first to arrive on the scene, and I'll be the last to leave. This is what God's telling him. I'm your homeland security protection. The rod of correction, the rod of protection, the rod of blessing. That's who I am. I'm Yahweh. Now watch this. Jeremiah would have been fearful to carry God's message to Israel if, somebody say if, God had not promised to protect him. God, he said, don't be afraid of their faces, Jeremiah. I'm awake. I'm woke. And I will protect you. Huh? In the volatile climate that Jeremiah lived, those words had great source of comfort.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, God offers us the same homeland security that he afforded Jeremiah when he carried the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ into the world. We don't have to be afraid of rejection or of persecution. God is awake. God is awake. We need to be woke.
Yeah.
He'll protect us. God is the awake tree. Somebody might miss this, but I want you to hear something here. Something very valuable about this tree that we're going to talk about here. Listen, this tree was something very important. But in order for you to see, we got to unravel the analogies here. See, the Hebrew word for almond tree, the shoked, which means to watch or to wait. Yeah. So the almond tree was known as the awake tree because in Palestine, the almond tree is the first tree of the year to bud and bear fruit. In fact, the bloom of the almond tree comes before the leaves. Yes, much like the cherry blossoms. Everybody serves and honors the cherry blossoms, but the almond tree blooms before the cherry trees and the magnolia trees. In Palestine climate, it burst into bloom in January. The almond tree represents God, who was watching to see that his word was fulfilled. I wish I had a witness, because God called me, and before I got in the womb, God said, I'm the wake tree, and I'm waiting on you, and I will protect you wherever you go. Don't worry, I'll be with you. So Jeremiah had the comforting words of God that I watch over you. Can I get a witness here? And I don't know if that's anything to shout for, but I'm here to tell you that when God is telling you, awake, arise, get up, because I'm going to protect you. God is my awake tree. He's my almond tree. I want you to know that no matter what you say, let God touch your lips and allow him to come before you. Hallelujah for the Lamb. I'm thankful today that God is not my cold orange, but he's my cold almond, because he's my awake and he watches over me. Hasn't he done something for you already? He will protect you. Hasn't he delivered you time and time again? You ought to say, thank you, Lord. If God has blessed you real good, somebody honk your horn. Somebody type hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm woke. Thank you for awakening me. Hallelujah. You got to hear the cries. Hallelujah. Jeremiah cried for the people because he cared for them. I care for this nation. I care for my family. I care for our community. And I'm crying in my spirit because of the hatred that is being bred throughout our country and our land. But God has awoken me. I know y'all didn't hear that. God has awoken me. I know y'all grammar specialists out there. But God awoke me so that I'll preach to the captives to set them free. Hallelujah. So we thank God for this blessing. Hallelujah. I want to invite and extend an invitation to Christ to those that may not know the Lord for the full pardon of your sin. You need to realize that salvation is the condition of being forgiven of our sins. I've done a lot of things in my life, but thanks be to God that when I go to Christ, Christ's blood that was spilled on the Calvary, the drop, just a smidgen, gets on my life. And when God looks at me, he don't see Leon, he sees Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah. And God fulfills us. And I need to understand that Jesus, God's son, satisfied the judgment of those who believe in him. And I'm here to tell you that the righteous judge, Jesus, will help us to enter into the kingdom. Yes. He died for our sins. Yes, taking the punishment that we deserve. Went to the grave. Said he was down there a long time preaching. Took away the keys of death and hell. Rose up early on a Sunday morning. Yes, then they said he walked around earth for 40 days before ascending to his Father. But the promise is he's coming back. Yes. Hallelujah. So I'm here to tell you, I want to give an opportunity for those that may not know the Lord, or maybe you've fallen away. God has awakened you. Today, you awoke, and we want to extend that hand of friendship to you. Go to our webpage, www.mountcarmelcbc.org, and at the upper right-hand corner of that page says Connect, and over there's two options, prayer requests and for accepting Christ. Please don't rush through it, but read through it. It has valuable information. If you are in need of a church home, consider Mount Carmel, the mountain on the south side. Not that we're being arrogant, but we're tired of being valley dwellers, and God is telling us to climb up the rough side of the mountain. Everything will be all right. I'm just thankful today for what God has done. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, thank you for the victory and power of your name. Thank you for holding the keys of over death and that you and sit your might. Thank you, Jesus, who raised from the grave, paving the way for us to live a new life with you. Thank you, Lord, for your plan. Thank you for making me to see that I can be awakened. Lord, we thank you for covering, for protection, for power, for your presence in our lives. Gracious Lord, we recognize your immutability, that you've never changed. Father, we know that we are going to face the uncertainty of our future. Please, God, give us strength to endure. For the up-and-coming leadership of America, please, Lord, give them clarity, fortitude, and conviction of your word to move the United States of America forward under the umbrella, Father, of that statement, "In God we trust." Father, for the transitional period of the leadership change, please, Lord, help us to be patient to run this race. Father, please guard our hearts, our minds, restore our mental and emotional resources that have been depleted. Father, let us not become weary in doing good works. Father, shine your light all around us, through us, and over us. Father, may we make a difference in our part of the world. For your glory, for your purpose, set your ways before us, Lord. May all of your plans succeed in our lives. Help us to reflect. Help us to grab onto your peace. Help us to hold on to that hope that the world so desperately needs. Thank you, Lord God, for your indescribable gift of Jesus, who died on the cross of Calvary, but didn't stay dead, but got up. Father, thank you for the presence of your Holy Spirit. Father, we ask for the Pentecostal presence in our lives, that we'll move forward in that path that you have us to journey on. Father, to you be glory, honor, forever and forever. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. 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 God bless you. Thank you for being with us today. We pray that this message of the awakening was something that was hopeful. I pray that you will realize differently about the almond tree and who God is in our lives. I want you to know that God claimed you before life began. Yeah. In the name of Jesus, I declare and decree freedom on that individual that is in need right now. Father, I declare and decree, Father, bondage breaking power right now. Yeah. Father, help us to be delivered, to be awakened, and to be woke. In Jesus we pray. Amen. God bless you. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us, unto him be glory of the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. In Jesus' name we pray and we say amen, amen, amen. Go in peace, and may the peace of God go with you. See you next week by the grace of God. We love you. Amen. 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 16 and 17. Yes, I do. And so I'm no more, neither shall they thirst anymore.